Dear children, welcome back to our class. We are learning about solving quadratic equations using formula or factorization. And the previous class, we have started solving the word problems. Look at example 3.38 in your book. Example 3.38 on page number 115 of your book. Go through the question. A flock of swans contained x square numbers. Flock means group. Group of swans contained how many numbers? X square numbers. As the clouds gather, that is the weather changes. So as the clouds gather, 10x went to a lake. How many went to a lake? 10x. And 1/8 of the members flew away to a garden. How many of them flew away to a garden? 1/8 of the members. How many members are there? X square members. Then 1/9 of x square went to the garden. The remaining 3 pairs played about in the water. 3 pairs. A pair consists of 2. Then 3 pairs means 3 into 2, 6 of them are playing in the water. How many swans were there in total? We are asked to find the total number of swans. So let us write down the data. What are given there? How many total number of swans are there? X square. Total swans equal to x square. Total swans equal to x square. How many went to the lake? 10x went to the lake. How many of them flew to the garden? 1/8 of the members. Members are x square. So 1/8 of x square. And how many were playing? Remaining were playing in the water. How many were there? 3 pairs. 3 pairs means 3 into 2, 6. So these are the data given. Total swans equal to x square. Number of the swans went to lake is equal to 10x. Number of the swans flew to garden is equal to 1/8 x square. And remaining are 6. From this data, we have to frame a quadratic equation. That is, the total number of swans minus number of swans went to lake minus number of swans flew to the garden, then the remaining is equal to 6. So x square, total number of swans, minus number of swans went to the lake minus 10x, and then minus number of swans flew to the garden, 1/8 x square, that is equal to 6. The remaining is equal to 6. How does that 6 come? 3 pairs, 3 into 2, 6. So let us make it into a proper quadratic equation. Take this 8 as LCM, this becomes 8x square, minus 10x becomes minus 80x, minus 1, 1 into this x square is equal, by 8 is equal to 6. Then take this 8 to that side, 6 into 8 is equal to 48. 8x square and minus x square like terms, so simplify them as 7x square. 7x square minus 80x is equal to 48. Bring this 48 to this side, this will become minus 48. 7x square minus 80x minus 48 is equal to 0. This is the proper quadratic equation we have framed from the given information. This is some difficult equation. So we will use formula method to solve this. Let us find what is A, what is B, what is C from the given equation. A is equal to 7, B is equal to minus 80, and C is equal to minus 48. And what's the quadratic formula? X is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Then substitute the values of a, b and c in this. Minus b, b is minus 80, so minus b is equal to plus 80 plus or minus b square minus 80 the whole square minus 4ac, minus 4 in the place of a 7, in the place of c minus 48. Divided by 2a in the place of a 7, 2 into 7. Then minus 80 the whole square is 6400. Then minus 4 sevens are 28. 28 into 48 is 1344. Here is a minus, there is a minus. Minus into minus will become plus. Then 2 sevens are 14. Then 80 plus or minus, add these two numbers. 6400 plus 1344 is equal to 7744 divided by 14. Take the square root of 7744. Use the long division method, what you are learning in 8th standard. The square root of 7744 is equal to 88. So 80 plus or minus 88 by 14. Then x is equal to either 80 plus 88 by 14 or 80 minus 88 by 14. Equal to 168 by 14 or minus 8 by 14. 80 plus 88, 168. 80 minus 8 is minus 8. Let us simplify this. Divide 168 by 14, which is equal to 12. Then minus 8 by 14 can be cancelled into minus 4 by 7. But x is the number of, it determines the number of swans. So it cannot be equal to minus 1, 4 by 7. X should be a whole number, not a rational number. So x is equal to minus 4 by 7 is not possible. Therefore, we have to take x is equal to 12. Total number of swans we have to find. Total number of swans is equal to x square. So in the place of x, substitute 12. 12 square is equal to 144. So total number of swans in the flock is equal to 144. Next sum. Look at example 3.39. It says about two trains. One is express train, another one is a passenger train. Go through the sum. A passenger train takes 1 hour more than an express train to travel a distance of 240 km from Chennai to Virudhachalam. You all know that passenger train is always slower than the express train. Here, what's the difference given about the time taken by the two trains? A passenger train takes 1 hour more than an express train. What's the distance given? Distance is equal to 240 km. And they say about the speed of the passenger train and express train also. The speed of passenger train is less than of an express train by 20 km. Speed of the passenger train is 20 km less than the express train. We can say that the express train goes 20 km faster than the passenger train. They are asked to find the average speed of both the trains. They are asked to find what is the speed of the passenger train and also the what is the speed of the express train. So let us write down the given data. We are asked to find the average speed of the passenger train and also the average speed of the express train. So let us assume the variables for that. Let the average speed of the passenger train be x kilometer per hour. Average speed of the passenger train we have assumed as x kilometer per hour. And average speed of the express train be x plus 20 kilometer per hour. Why we have written plus 20? Express train is 20 kilometer faster than the passenger train. But it is given that passenger train is 20 kilometer slower than the express train. We can take it like this also. So express train is speed is x plus 20. Suppose if you assume the speed of the express train be x kilometer, we have to assume the passenger train speed be x minus 20 kilometer. Now let us take the distance. Distance is equal to 240 kilometer. The sum also deals about this time. How to calculate the time? Time is equal to distance divided by speed. Distance, speed and time are related with one another. So time is equal to distance divided by speed. So let us assume the time taken by the passenger train and also the express train. The time taken by the passenger train be T1. Then T1 is equal to, what's the distance? 240. Divided by, what's the speed of the passenger train? X kilometer per hour. So 240 by X. That's the time taken 1 by the passenger train is T1. That is equal to distance 240 divided by passenger train speed X kilometer per hour. So X. Then there is the time taken by the express train be T2. T2 is equal to, distance is the same, 240 divided by, what's the speed of the express train? It is x plus 20. So that should be written 240 by x plus 20. So time taken by the passenger train should be T1, time taken by the express train be T2. And it is given that express train takes 1 hour less than the passenger train. Or passenger train takes 1 hour more than the express train. Time taken by the passenger train is greater than the time taken by the express train. So T1 is greater than T2 by 1. Or the difference between T1 and T2 is equal to 1 hour. You understand that? The time taken by the passenger train is 1 hour more than the time taken by the express train. What's the time taken by the passenger train? T1. What's the time taken by the express train? T2. So T1 is 1 hour greater than T2. Difference between T1 and T2 is equal to 1 hour. From that only we are going to frame the quadratic equation. Time taken by the passenger train is 1 hour more than the time taken by the express train. So time taken by the passenger train T1 minus time taken by the express train T2 is equal to 1 hour. What is T1 we found? 240 by X. minus T2 is 240 by x plus 20. That is equal to 1. Now, to simplify this, to make it a quadratic equation, let us take 240 as common. When you take 240 as common, this becomes 1 by x minus 1 by x plus 20 is equal to 1. Now, take LCM of these two expressions, x and x plus 20, the LCM is x of x plus 20. Then this one is multiplied by x plus 20, this one is multiplied by x. So, x plus 20 minus x by x of x plus 20. Then, simplify this again, x and minus x will be cancelled, numerator is just 20. Multiply these two terms by x, x into x, x square, x into 20 is plus 20x. Then multiply this 240 into 20, which is equal to 4800 by x square plus 20x is equal to 1. Take this to that side. So 4800 is equal to x square plus 20x. So make this a proper quadratic equation, x square plus 20x. Take this 4800 to that side. Minus 4800 is equal to 0. Now this is the proper quadratic equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Now this can be easily factorizable, so we can use the factorization method. Suppose if you feel difficult to factorize it, you can use the formula method also. Here I used the factorization method. Two numbers, if you multiply them, minus 4800, if you add them 20, the answer should be 20. So let us select 80 and minus 60. 80 into minus 60 is minus 4800. 80 minus 60 is equal to plus 20. So this is x plus 80 or x minus 60 is equal to 0. If x plus 80 is equal to 0, then x is equal to minus 80. If x minus 60 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 60. But x cannot be negative. Why x cannot be negative? Because x is the speed. Speed cannot be in negative. Therefore, we have to take x is equal to 60. So, average speed of the passenger train is equal to 60 km per hour. Average speed of the express train is x plus 20, 60 plus 20, 80 km per hour. Exercise 3.12, two sums were given as common, first sum and ninth sum. We will see the solution of that sums. Look at the first sum, very simple sum. If the difference between a number and its reciprocal is 24 by 5. It is just says about a number. The difference between a number and its reciprocal is 24 by 5. Find the number. So let us then assume the number be x. If the number be x and its reciprocal be 1 by x. And what's the data given? Difference between a number and its reciprocal. Therefore, x minus 1 by x. Why I have written minus? Difference. Difference means we have to subtract. X minus 1 by x is equal to 24 by 5. Then take x as LCM, it becomes x square. X square minus 1 by x is equal to 24 by 5. Then cross multiply that, 5 of x square minus 1 is equal to 24 into x, 24x. Multiply both of these terms by 5. 5 x square minus 5. Then bring this 24x to this side. Minus 24x is equal to 0. Arrange it to a proper quadratic equation. 5x square minus 24x minus 5 is equal to 0. This is a proper quadratic equation. Use factorization method to solve this. 5 5s are 25. So we have to select two numbers. If we multiply the numbers, it should be minus 25. If you add the numbers, sum should be minus 24. So numbers are minus 25 and 1. Divide them by the coefficient of x square. So minus 25 by 5, 1 by 5. Cancel these two. Then this is x minus 5 and 5x minus 1 equal to 0. These are two linear factors of this quadratic equation. If x minus 5 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 5. 5x minus 1 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 1 by 5. So here both the answers is applicable because it simply said that a number, some difference between a number and reciprocal. The number may be a whole number or a rational number, any of the number. So both of the numbers should be taken as the answer. So the number is equal to 5 or 1 by 5. Check your answers. 9. Look at the question. The hypotenuse of a right angle triangle is 25 cm and its perimeter is 56 cm. The sum is about a right angle triangle. In right angle triangle, the longest side is hypotenuse. Do you know that? What's the longest side of a right angle triangle? The hypotenuse. So what's the measurement of the hypotenuse given? Hypotenuse is equal to 25 cm. And its perimeter is equal to 56 cm. We're asked to find the smallest side. So let us assume the sides of the triangle will be A, B and C. The sides of the triangle will be A, B and C. And C is the longest side, which is opposite to 90 degree, is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is equal to, C is equal to 25 centimeter. And perimeter is given as 56 centimeter. Perimeter of a triangle is sum of the three sides of a triangle. How to calculate the perimeter of a triangle? Sum of the three sides of a triangle. What are the three sides here? A, B and C. Sum of them means A plus B plus C is equal to 56 centimeter. In the substitute, C is equal to 25. So A plus B plus 25 is equal to 56. It gives you A plus B is equal to 56 minus 25. Then A plus B is equal to 31. From this we got a derivation for B. B is equal to 31 minus A. Why do you derive like this? We have to substitute same variables in an equation. For that purpose, I have to decide to change all the variables as A. So we derived B is equal to 31 minus A. By Pythagoras theorem, already know that. What the Pythagoras theorem says? In a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. What's hypotenuse here? C. So C square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides, that's A square plus B square. In a right angle triangle, hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. Therefore here C square is equal to A square plus B square. Substitute the value, C is 25, so 25 square is equal to A square plus B. We have derived as 31 minus A. Substitute that value for B square, 31 minus A the whole square. Then 25 square is 625, this A square as it is we have written here, plus this 31 minus A the whole square should be written in the form A minus B the whole square. What's the expansion of A minus B the whole square? A square minus 2AB plus B square. In the place of A, you substitute 31, 31 square is equal to 961, minus 2AB, 2 into 31 into A, that is equal to minus 62A. Plus B square is equal to here A square. So this is the expansion of 31 minus A the whole square. Then simplify this, A square plus A square, like terms can be added up. So 2A square minus 62A, arrange it in order, plus 961. Next step, take this 625 to that side, it comes there as minus 625. Why we are changing that? To make it into a proper quadratic equation. So 2a square minus 62a plus 961 minus 625 is equal to 0, which is 2a square minus 62a plus 336 is equal to 0. This can be further simplified because all these three terms can be divided by 2. So divide all these three terms by 2, then this a square minus 31a plus 168 is equal to 0. Now we got from the given information, we derived a proper quadratic equation. This quadratic equation into two linear factors, we have to select two numbers. Here it's a simple equation, so I am selecting the factoring method. The two numbers, if you multiply them, the product should be 168. If you add them up, the sum should be minus 31. The two numbers are minus 24 and minus 7. What does this 1 stand for? The coefficient of A square, that is 1. So it should be factorized as A minus 24 and A minus 7 is equal to 0. Children, what's the variable here that should be used? Okay, A is the variable here. So factorized it as A minus 24 and A minus 7 is equal to 0. From this we get A is equal to 24 or 7. Both the answers are applicable to A, but here A be the smallest sign. So we have to take A is equal to 7. And what is B? B is equal to 31 minus A. So B is equal to 24 centimeter. And C is already given, the sum as 25 centimeter. So the answer, the three sides of the triangle are 7, 24 centimeter and also 25 centimeter. Children, homework is go through the four sums which are taught in the class. And copy down the sums in the fan note and also practice the sums in rough note. That's the homework. Because as they are the statement sums, while seeing the question, you must know how to derive the equation and solve them. So practice these four sums in your rough note as a homework. Thank you, children.